So, today I got sent a picture yesterday of a young boy, actually a bunch of young boys, but this one out of the whole group was standing there looking at some guy standing on a pole. It's like one of these funny pictures that people send out in emails, you know. But what my eyes focused on were was a little boy standing in the back, and I could see how his arms were. All their arms were in the back behind him like this one, and I could see immediately that I was so wrong on the way I positioned his arms. And so I'm going to cut these off and redo them. So let's get started on that right now. The one thing I did notice in the picture was the elbow was much lower than what I had it. And it's because kids are not proportional to humans, I mean to full-grown people. And so instead of being up underneath his rib, it would be down closer to where his hip is. And so that's what I got to do right now, is just lengthen the arm. Funny how you don't notice things because you're not, you know, I mean, I don't hang out with kids and look at them, I mean, all day, but just didn't realize how off I was. And his wrist would be down, actually below his, where it should be. So his arms would be just a little bit lower than normal, and instead of disappearing from the front, they'd just be angled differently. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm thinking of having him holding his shaps, or chinks, as they call them. These would be short shaps, not necessarily long ones. Or long ones, I don't know. And he's looking up at his dad with this look, and he's saying, "Dad, can I ride with you today?" I think that's kind of a cute title. Somebody suggested I just call it Cowboy. That's a great title, but I think the other one says more. It's a longer title, but it just says what I want it to show. It's this little boy standing there wanting to go ride with his dad. The way I had his arms tightly behind him, it changed the back of his back. So now I think it looks a lot better now. I can see his arms from the front. I'm not going to worry about the arms right now. I just need to get started on the pants leg, or at least the boot. And so that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to have him kind of pigeon-toed as well. I think that can make it kind of look kind of cool. Okay, this is what I've done. I can't get any more height on this turntable, or this sculpting stand. So I built a little box, so to speak, where I can store my tools, where it raises it up to a point where I can see straight at the boots. I don't want to be looking down at them because I'm not seeing them properly. I can't work on the heel and the sole of the boot if it's down here, because then I'm constantly looking down like this. So I built this, and I just attach it to the turntable on the sculpting stand so that I can raise it up to the height that I need. Simple solution to a problem, whereas some people would probably just go out and buy a new sculpting stand. I find it much more economical to just build a little tiny box. Thank you.
All right, one of the things you have to pay attention to when you're sculpting wrinkles in clothing, and especially when you've sculpted the body underneath it, don't cut into the leg or the chest of the figure with wrinkles. It has to go right to the surface of the leg or right to the surface of the body. My distant uncle, who's a sculptor also, gave me that pointer a long time ago. The first piece I ever did was called The Frontiersman. It was a bust of a gentleman that looked something like Buffalo Bill. It wasn't meant to be Buffalo Bill, but it looked like him. And it was just a bust with a neckerchief around his neck, and I had that neckerchief, the wrinkles in the neckerchief, I thought were beautiful. I'd worked for days on the wrinkles. And I took it to have him look at it, and they gave me up pointers, and he looked at it and instantly saw that one of the wrinkles was below the chest line. In other words, it had cut into the chest. And he told me, he says, you have to always be mindful of the body underneath the clothing, and you'd never want the wrinkles to be deeper than the leg is or the chest is. And I've never forgotten that lesson. So I'm passing that knowledge on to you guys. Always be mindful where the body is. Don't make your wrinkles too deep. Always be mindful that you're not cutting into the body, you're on top of the body. I'm making these pants really kind of baggy. Because if you see little kids around here in Montana, little ranch kids, they wear baggy clothes, and it's usually hand-me-downs too. It's being a rancher is not exactly being rich. You tend to use hand-me-down clothing, and this may be hand-me-down pants that may have been on his brother when he was young. So that's for now just one leg, and like I said, I'm working from this photograph of a little boy, and I'm sort of trying to match the wrinkles in the pants leg and the form of the pants leg so that as a kind of like a basis for the rest of it, so I can continue the feel all the way around the pants leg. I've got to figure out what this is going to look like in here, how it's going to look like on the inside of the leg, and how this side of the leg is going to look. I think it's easy once you lay down a basis in wrinkles. So, all right, that's going to be it for today. First, I'm going to do one thing. I'm going to set the center line of his pants leg, because this is where the seam will run. It's right straight down this pants leg here, like that. And I'll put that seam in tomorrow. All right, have a good night, everybody. That's it for today.